Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs for 16th of January, so let's start the video. On January the 15th, 2019, which edition of the Army Day was celebrated across the country? First of all, you must remember, why do we celebrate the Army Day? So Indian Army, you know, the last British chief was F.R.R. Bucher. Remember his name? F.R.R. Bucher. He was the last British Army chief, and then we started having Indian Army chiefs. The first one was K.M. Karyappa. K.M. Karyappa was the first Indian Army chief, and this transition day is the Army Day. So basically, this day is celebrated every year to commemorate the day when General K.M. Karyappa took over as the Chief of Army. It was the first time an Indian became the Army Chief, and that is why this day is historic. It was the 71st edition of the Army Day. And the date was 15 January 1949. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched and he had let down the foundation stone of several development projects worth 1500 crore rupees for which state recently? He did it for Odisha. Now also remember that there is a multimodal logistics park. Don't forget it. There is a multimodal logistics park that has been set up in Jharsuguda in Odisha. And Odisha has been news for a lot of reasons, okay, recently. So there is a scheme called Pitha that was started in Odisha. There is a scheme called Kalia that has been started. And in fact, there is a scheme which has been started just today on 16th of January called Sunetra scheme, which is basically for free eye treatment checkup, you know, free eye checkup for all the citizens of Odisha. It is called Sunetra. Netra means eyes, okay, that's how you remember it. And then there is a scheme called Saur Jal Nidhi scheme that was also started by the government of Odisha. Recently, the third international airport of Odisha has been opened in Rourkela. So Rourkela is the latest airport to get opened in Odisha. Before this, Odisha has had only two international airports, one in Bhubaneswar, which is the Biju Patnaik International Airport, and the second one is the Veer Surendra Sai Airport in Jharsuguda. There was a Google Doodle. So this is what you call a Google Doodle, where Google actually pays tribute to one historic figure. So Google Doodle celebrated Anglo-Indian entrepreneur Sheikh Dean Mahmood. He was born in which city? He was born in the city of Patna, which is actually the capital of Bihar. And Pune was Patna, okay, not Pune. So Patna, it was called Patliputra. It was called Patliputra in the ancient times. Which state's traffic police has inducted a road safety robot, which is called Rodeo, into service for traffic management? This has been done by the government of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has introduced the robot in Chennai. And it will basically ease the work of traffic police, as the robot can be integrated with the traffic signal. And in fact, the robot can be operated through Bluetooth app also manually. So the answer is Tamil Nadu. And recently, an airport has been let down. Foundation stone has been let down for an airport in Tuticorin. It will be completed in 4 years. Who has become the youngest gold medalist at the Khelo India Youth Games? The youngest gold medalist is 10-year-old Abhinav Shaw. Abhinav Shaw. So he won it in shooting. And he teamed up with Mehuli Ghosh. He is from West Bengal. So remember that also. Abhinav Shaw is from West Bengal. Now there is another player called Prithvi Shaw. There is a player called Prithvi Shaw. Can you tell me Prithvi Shaw plays which sport? Write down in comments. Which team has won the Premier Badminton League title? The Premier Badminton League title was won by Bengaluru Raptors. Now please don't confuse Bengaluru Raptors with Bengaluru Bulls. Okay. Bengaluru Bulls won the Kabaddi, Pro Kabaddi League. Okay. They beat Gujarat Fortune Giants, if you remember. So Bengaluru Bulls is the Premier Kabaddi League champion, and Bengaluru Raptors is the Premier Badminton League champion. Okay. So, and whom did they defeat? Bengaluru Raptors defeated Mumbai Rockets in the final. Mumbai Rockets were the finalists. Civil Aviation Minister Suresh Prabhu on 15th of January 2019 inaugurated the Global Aviation Summit in which city? Global Aviation Summit was inaugurated in Mumbai, and the more important question is, what was the theme? So the theme was Flying for All, Flying for All, especially the next 6 billion. Flying for All, especially the next 6 billion. This was the theme. Now another question can come, which is that the Ministry for Civil Aviation, they have organized the Global Aviation Summit in association with which organization? The answer is FICCI. FICCI. And as I told you earlier also, that in Odisha, a new airport has opened in Rourkela. This is the third airport in Odisha. And in Andhra Pradesh, a new airport has recently been opened in Kurnool. I repeat, a new airport in Andhra Pradesh has been opened in Kurnool. Now, please don't confuse Kurnool with Kannur, because a new airport in Kerala has been opened in Kannur. Which union territory has decided to ban the production, sale and use of single-use plastic products in the union territory from March the 1st? Which union territory is this? It is Pondicherry. So they have decided to ban single-use plastic, and Chief Minister is Mr. V. Narayanaswamy. Mr. V. Narayanaswamy. L.B. Morkel, who has announced his retirement from all forms of cricket, played cricket for which country? He played cricket for South Africa. South Africa, Cyril Ramaphosa will be our Republic Chief Guest. He is the President of South Africa. Now remember, there is a South African bowler called Dale Steyn, and he has become the all-time leading test wicket taker from South Africa, and he beat the record of Sean Pollock. The Armed Force Veterans Day was observed on which date? Armed Force Veterans Day, we celebrate to honor the veterans of the Army, Navy and Air Force. So it is not just about Army, it is the Armed Forces Veterans Day. Okay, we celebrate it on 14th of January. Name the former Goa Ranji player who passed away at the age of 47 while playing at the Margao Cricket Club tournament. So he died while playing. His name was Rajesh Ghodge. Rajesh Ghodge. Second International Sweet Festival was inaugurated by the Vice President Venkaiah Naidu in which city? It was inaugurated in the capital of Telangana, that is Hyderabad. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley and Union Minorities Affairs Minister Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, they have inaugurated Hunar Haat exhibition in which city? Hunar Haat exhibition was inaugurated at the State Emporia Complex in New Delhi. The answer is New Delhi. Hunar Haat is basically, the artisans and the craftsmen, they showcase their skills in these Hunar Haats. So these are important for the branding of our national and international heritage for master artisans. Who has resigned as the chairman of TERI, the Energy and Resources Institute? It is Ashok Chawla. Ashok Chawla has resigned. Nitin Gadkari has released the inaugural issue of which monthly magazine of the Ministry for Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation? This magazine is Jal Charcha. It will be called Jal Charcha. Jal means water, charcha means discussion or a dialogue or a talk. Okay, that is, so it is basically a dialogue on water. Yellow Vest protest, which is in the news, was first raised in which country? Yellow Vest protests were raised in France. And why? What are Yellow Vest protests? So basically France has put a lot of taxes on the energy sources, making the petrol, diesel, etc. very costly for the common people. And also there is a huge rise in inflation in France. As a result, Emmanuel Macron, the president of France, his popularity is decreasing. And the young people, so basically Yellow Vest protest is basically by young people. And it's a protest where these people are, they are wearing the highly visible jackets, colored yellow. And there is an anger over the fuel tax hike. All India Radio has permitted which of its program or service to be carried in unaltered form by private FM channels as per certain terms and condition? They have permitted which of the program or service to be carried in unaltered form? These are the Hindi and English news. The answer is B. India's largest startup ecosystem was inaugurated in which state? It was recently inaugurated in Kerala. Kerala and it's a 1.8 lakh square feet facility that was inaugurated by the minister, Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan. So the answer is Kerala. Now in the last question, let me ask you a difficult question. So Mahatma Gandhi, he visited All India Radio office, but only once in his life. And that day is celebrated as what, and it falls on which day? Can you write down in comments? Ama Ghare LED is a scheme launched by which state? Ama Ghare LED, which means we'll put LED in our homes, in our own homes. Okay. Ama Ghare LED has been started by the government of Odisha. And 95 lakh families in the state, they will get LED bulbs free of cost. Which High Court has formed an expert committee to suggest ways and means to remove the invasive species of the plants from the Western Ghats and rehabilitate the forests? Which High Court we are talking about? We are talking about the Madras High Court. The Madras High Court. The invasive species of the plant are one of the largest causes of the loss of biodiversity. You know, can you name at least one or two important invasive species from India? Let's see who answers this question. Fourth meeting of the Council for Trade Development and Promotion, that is CTDP, was held where? It was held in Delhi. Pradhan Mantri Modi will inaugurate the 15th Pravasi Bharatiya Divas on 21st of Jan in which city? This time it will be celebrated in Varanasi. Varanasi is also the Lok Sabha constituency of Pradhan Mantri Modi. And Pravasi Bharatiya Divas is celebrated on 9th of January every year to mark the homecoming of Mahatma Gandhi from South Africa. Bibi Ka Makbara was built by whom? Bibi Ka Makbara was built by Azam Shah. He was son of Aurangzeb, and Bibi Ka Makbara is in Aurangabad, named after Aurangzeb. So he built it in the memory of his mother, Rabia Ud Durrani, who was the wife of Aurangzeb and Azam Shah's mother. There is a book called Glimpses of World History. It has been written by which person? It's a book published by Jawaharlal Nehru. So the answer is Jawaharlal Nehru. And he wrote this book, so basically it's a collection of 196 letters on world history written from various prisons, you know. The study of the universe is called what? It is called cosmology. Now please don't confuse cosmology with exobiology. Lot of people confuse it. Exobiology is basically the study of the possibility of life in the outer space. You know, that is called exobiology. The Minister for Human Resource Development, Prakash Javadekar, he has announced a how much percent increase in seats across educational institutions in order to ensure that 10% reservation recently given to the economically weaker sections of the upper caste. There will be 25% increase in the college seats in India, all over India. This is to make sure that because of the 10% extra reservation, nobody loses out. So 25% seats will be increased all over India. So this was the video for 16th of January. I will come up with more videos today. Thank you so much for watching and keep supporting StudyIQ.